The Case-Shiller Home Price Index had the biggest year-over-year decrease since December 2009. I want to get over to Bloomberg Surveillance, where Case-Shiller founder Carl Case is speaking with Tom Keen and Ken Pruitt. Let's listen in.
Where we'll get to, we're now negative two. Negative will we get on that?
We're not in the business of forecasting, and it's so tough to call turns in the market. I mean, it looked like we really had one. If you go back to the spring of 2009, house prices bottomed, and there was a pretty good recovery for a period of about 6 or 8 months. It peaked in November of last year, and then it was downhill from there. And so it looks like it was a recovery stimulated by the housing tax credit and the rest of the subsidies. No, lest we forget that there's a massive amount of subsidy going into this sector, and we're still guaranteeing practically every loan through the FHA or through Fannie and Freddie. So it's discouraging, but there's a lot of negatives in the underlying numbers.
Well, how much of a question mark does the foreclosure situation calls for the market? I mean, everything's kind of on hold now, but that just means it's going to start up again whenever they get the paperwork straightened out.
Yeah, I mean, it's there's big numbers out there. I mean, some people say there's as many as 12 million underwater properties, and that's going to keep pressure on the market. I mean, it's not that all the news is bad. The unemployment numbers are bad. The vacancy numbers are bad. But there's signs that people's mood's picking up. Believe it or not, it doesn't take a lot of people to move the market. If people's mood actually changes, there's only about 6 or 7% of the properties go through the market in a given period, and it's on that that we base our view of what's going on in the whole marketplace.
Carl, I want to bring this chart up. Victor, see if you can get in here with this chart. Folks on radio, it's just comparing Phoenix and New York. I'll show this on Surveillance Midday today. The white line is persistently up as New York through the 2000 to 2006 period. Phoenix is a little laggard, but it's remarkable how New York and Phoenix end up in the same place from 2000 to 2006. And then what a difference, Carl Case. Can we still make the statement that all real estate is local?
You can't in the latter part of this decade, but certainly in the front part. Bob Shiller and I ran some correlations the other day. We looked at the degree of correlation within these indexes across cities. They're not very correlated in the first 5 years of the decade, but in the last 5 years, they are highly correlated, and I think the reason is one of the causes of this downturn was the expansion of credit at the low end. And that hit everybody, whether they had a boom or whatever going before that. So that tremendous increase in credit, if you look at the low level, our low tier index, they go booming in almost every city, and then they drop like a rock. So it's still true that if you look at Florida, Arizona, Nevada, they're just terribly overbuilt, and there's a lot of land out there, and that's going to take a long time to correct. Midwest is in the doldrums. Look at the unemployment rates of the Midwest, and you see numbers in the mid-teens. And so the unemployment problem is plaguing the Midwest, and the overpricing is really what happened to California, at least on the coast. And then California is a third of the country, and it's really beginning to come back. So it really is still true that markets are pretty local.
Well, the easy credit days for sure are over, but what do you make of the fact that since last fall we've seen the nationwide average for 30-year fixed go from about 4.2 to about 5.3 now?
Well, that's what we wanted. We wanted to price this risk. We were underpricing it, and all of a sudden the banks are behaving the way the new legislation was really trying to get them to behave. They're being more cautious, and rates are going up to reflect that risk, and indeed people are not getting credit. That's what's holding the market back in part, at least in the areas where you don't have this tremendous overbuilding. There, it's going to take time.
What will be the catalyst to jumpstart?
Well, that was Case-Shiller founder Carl Case on Bloomberg Surveillance talking about the outlook for the housing market.